15 minutes as well. There you can see the start list there.
Please welcome the athletes for the final of men's 1500 meter freestyle.
There you have it, two Japanese. Long distance event. None of these swimmers bothering with a long haul in the water. Straight up and out.
But interesting, we saw Jay Lennon spend 7 to 8 meters in the water for every wall in the Olympic freestyle. I don't know whether he will do the same here. That's probably 6.5 to 7.
Lachlan's our early leader ahead of the Japanese Girai.
And if you remember, Lachlan gave Lennon a hell of a run for his money in the 400 freestyle. So he went head-to-head all the way.
And he's second and third. 50 metre turn, but a lot of swimming to come here. Lachlan looking good in the lane closest to us. Yamamoto though, who leads ahead of his brother Japanese Hirai.
And again, Lelia from the 7 metres of the water.
Luther into third at the 100 metre mark then. Lachlan back into fourth.
And it's good to see that the two Japanese, Yamamoto and Hirai, are at the front of the race because you know, they have very good time. Yamamoto's best time is 14.4, Hirai's is 15 minutes. And I'd love to see a 3 or 4 way race here rather than one swim like it out ahead, staying out ahead with it.
It's early doors, but the lanes to look at for 6, 5 and 4. Jake Furlong. 3, there and thereabouts as well. Yamamoto still leads ahead of Hirai. Lely at 3rd. And now it's the Canadian Mackay who's 4th.
Now in the heat, Lely has built his speed up to 1,000 metres and then kind of held back and cruised, I think is probably the best way to say it. He cruised the last 500 and he was 15.08 in the heat. I think he's probably, I'm sure he wanted to do the best time after his outstanding, but personally best at 7.50 in the 800.
As we were then, Hirai leads from Yamamoto, Lely at 3rd, Roloff.
Lely seems very, very happy to let the two Japanese move away. He's about a body length behind. I assume he's very confident in his own pace and his own race plan.
Roloff virtually neck in neck with Lely. Japanese, they need to open up a lead though. Nicely in fourth.
If you remember the 800, Roloff just sat on Lely's shoulder all the way, stalked, and then made him do that. The last 100 and managed to just get ahead of Lely.
Lely was disappointed. He spoke to us after his gold medal, 400. And it motivated him to push even further, particularly that final length. He was chased all the way by the Australian Jack McLaughlin. Breathing down his neck as the Aussie.
If you remember, Lely refused to disclose what his target was for this 1500. I asked him if he, you know, if he had revised his pre-games target given how well he'd swum in the 800. He was very cagey, wouldn't really let on. I spoke to his coach later in the week, Mark Skinner, and Mark said that Jay won't even tell his girlfriend what his target is.
He's 1 and 2, Frolov. Now inched forward ahead of Lely. Centre of his lane, drifting towards that left-sided rope.
And Frolov has moved up a little bit, and Lely, it looks like he's responded to that, because what he doesn't want is to have people on either side ahead of him, and for him to be swimming in their turbulence.
There's 0.2 seconds separating two gold medalists, Lely in the 400, Frolov in the 800. Japanese who are leading the way. That's a very substantial lead for Ayetsuyu Hirai in 5. Hirai leads ahead of the Japanese Tony Yamamoto.
I think this is where we'll start to see Lely at push through, because I think he's going to try the very classical tactics of descending 500, so he's getting faster with each 500. He's just done 10 laps, so that's 500 metres. And then he's going to start to move up and crank up the pace a little bit.
That's a common tactic in the 1500 metres to divide the race into three parts.
Well, it's the classic target. Not many people manage to do it, but yeah, ideally you get faster on each 500. But he does need to make a move now, then, because Pirai has two body lengths. Jay Leno is coming in third. I don't know whether you can see that Yamamoto is also a body length.
Meters gone, Japan leading 1 and 2. Frolov and Elliott virtually neck and neck, buying it out for that third place, the bronze medal position.
And the good thing is that Elliott has Frolov for company. If they can work together, then you know, they keep pushing each other, they might be able to make inroads into the lead that I has at 650 meters.
It's been an excellent week so far in the pool for Japan, they're second in the medals table. 14 in total, 4 golds, 5 silver, 5 bronze. Who knows, could be enforced for another 2 here. That's Jay Elliott, Sergei Frolov. What are the ideas?
Hirai has a time of 15.01, that's 10th fastest in the world this year.
Right turns. In the lead, ahead of Yamamoto, Elliott. 60 minutes of a second in front of Frolov.
Still 3 seconds out of Elliott.
What's happening now then is that Elliott and Frolov are gradually eating into the lead of the second place winner, Hirai. Yamamoto, though, is out 5 seconds.
And this is the halfway point now, this is 750 metres. And Elliott and Frolov and Yamamoto have got some work to do.
Frolov and Elliott are trading the third place. Ukrainian's turn.
And Hirai is going to be very difficult to beat now because he's 7 metres ahead of Elliott in 4. Is around 6 metres ahead of Yamamoto and Frolov.
And am I right for thinking that Elliott said that this is his preferred distance?
Yeah, we asked him, didn't we, whether after his great performance in the 800, what his best event was, and he was absolutely adamant that this is the event that he trains for, this is his the event that's in his heart, and that he wouldn't start preparing, he wouldn't change his preparation to start racing. Training towards the 400 or the 800, which makes sense because in world terms his 400 is a little bit off the podium. The 800 is not swim at the Olympics, he's closer to the world top 10 on the 1500.
He said he has work to do because in his favourite distance he's trailing 4th place. Japan lead for the one and only Hirai. Frolov, yes he can. Frolov is going to second place for the first time ahead of Yamamoto, just by a tenth of a second. Can Elliott use Frolov to his right to spur him on?
Well, Frolov has moved over a body length ahead of Elliott now. Well, Elliott doesn't look dead, but he's going to have a hell of a last 500 if he wants to catch Hirai. And it looks like Frolov is the one that's decided now that Hirai needs to be caught.
We're ready with a gold medal to his name, 800 metres freestyle. And he is gaining ground, isn't he, on Hirai?
Yeah, it looks like he's kind of found his rhythm now, this Frolov.
I think that's a little spurt by Jay Lelliott as well. He seems to be gaining ground on the second of the Japanese, Yamamoto. Down, 600 to go. 560.
So at the moment, it's only here I inside 15 minutes pace, it's only 9.59 at the 1,000 metre mark.
Apologies, I'm 100 metres out. 2/3 of the race down. This is the final third. Frolov has certainly eaten into the lead, Pirai. But is it enough?
And there's 400 left.
Keep an eye on the scoreboard. Need to check the lead, Pirai. 2.5 seconds, 2.3 seconds. Yamamoto third, Lelliott fourth. And half a second between those two. Barring disaster for the front two, this is a two-man race.
It's also Yamamoto and Lelliott are battling for bronze. Well, it's two separate races now.
Agreed, that's the sub-race, the sub-plot.
But the big theme now is, can Frolov catch Yamamoto? Sorry, can he catch Hirai? He's only got just over 300 metres left to do it. Well, I think the odds are rather stacked against him, but he's such a strong finisher, as we saw in the 800.
Hirai turns in the lead. And his nearest challenger, Sergei Frolov. Yamamoto still holding off Jay Lelliott.
Yamamoto seems to have found an extra half a gear to move away from Lelliott.
Japan still looking at placing two men on the final podium.
And Hirai has just been so resolute, so determined. He's not letting Frolov get back on terms with him. Well, he's only got 200 metres now to catch a 3-second gap, which is it's not bad.
Race, Japanese to lose. And Sugu Hirai to provide another gold medal to that Japanese collection. Five.
He's moved away from Frolov.
Expecting the kick from Frolov. As you say, Japanese has found the extra gear. Mind the half gear.
First time that Hirai will go inside 15 minutes and join a very exclusive club.
Moto still in third. So still 2 second margin. Jim Elliott wants to add another medal to his collection. Bronze to complete the set, he needs to make a move. Shot. There's the bell. 100 metres to go for the Japanese leader, Hirai. He's not going to lose this. Frolov in second. Yamamoto turns in third. And I honestly can't see anything changing
order. You've got the gold, silver and bronze right there. Unless Yamamoto can find an incredible last 100 to catch Frolov. Frolov's still back. Apart from the medals, he'll be wanting to get inside 15 minutes again.
Yamamoto is closer to Frolov than Lelliott is to Yamamoto. The exertions of the lead put up to the fifth day innings.
Yeah, that's what I would guess. So it's going to be a bit of a emotional rollercoaster. A bit of a semi-high from doing such a great time in the 800, winning it. Kind of semi-high from winning the 400 but not being the best time.
keep around the clock then. He's going to go with the 15 metres. Hirai touches home, 14 minutes, 56.1. Another goal for Japan. Frolov hangs on to the silver medal. Japan have two men on the podium. As Kohei Yamamoto takes the bronze medal. What a game for Japan. Spare report for Jay Leliot. Finishing in the worst possible place.
15.07, yeah, he looks a little bit drained. He is capable of better than that, though. We know he is. He's got the best time of inside 15 minutes. And I think that...
He's delighted, isn't he? You saw his facial expression there. The race winner. Fantastic swim by Ayatsugu Hirai. And I think the extra celebration was because he realised he's dipped under 15 minutes.
Yeah, and not just dipped under, he smashed it with a 14.56.1.
It's all good for Ayatsugu Hirai. For the winning margin, Ben. Over 5 seconds. That's impressive. Over 6 seconds.
Not quite a Universiad record, but that was from Premislav Stanchik in 2009, who will have had the assistance of the polyurethane bodysuits.
So, the first final of this evening's session is completed. And it's good news for Japan. Gold and a bronze for their efforts. Separated by the Ukrainian Sergei Frolov.
And just to put Hirai's performance into context, that's moved him to third in the world rankings this year, behind Poltrinieri of Italy and Mac Horton of Australia. So some of the events here are of the highest quality. Others have been slightly weaker.